Hello student, my name is Bhagyadeep Kalal from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to my online lecture series of Basics of Automotive Systems. Today we will discuss about the chapter 4, in which topic number 2, that is the rear axles. Okay, so rear axle is nothing but it is a live shaft axles, that means it rotates with the wheel, or we can say it's a drive shaft which transfer a power from the engine to propeller shaft to the differential mechanism and to the rear axles. And rear axles is nothing but it is a one type of shaft which rotating with the help of differential mechanism. It is connected between differential mechanism and rear wheels. Okay, that's why it is known as the rear axles, and it is power transmitted to the rear wheel with the help of rear axle, because it is continuously rotates. That's why it is known as a live axles. Okay, so two types of axle is there, live axles and dead axles, in which axles which are rotating continuously, that is known as the rear axles, rear live axles. Okay, and front axles which are the non-rotating parts, that's why it is known as the dead axles. Okay, and one another axle, that is the center axles. Center axles is in between a propeller shaft. We can say propeller shaft is the center axles. Next we discuss about the rear axles, about rear axles, types of rear axles, and which type of rear axle design is used in our vehicles. Okay, an axle is a center shaft for rotating a wheel on a gears on a wheel vehicle. On wheeled vehicle, the axle may be fixed to the wheel, rotating with them on fixed to the vehicle, with the wheels rotating around the axle. Bearing and bushing are provided in the mounting points where the axle is supported. So this topic is already we covered it in the previous video lectures, but again I repeated and revised with a new topic. So in this diagram we have seen diagram, that is, this is our rear axles part. Okay, this is nothing but our rear axles, and it is connected between the differential mechanism. This is our differential mechanism, and this is nothing but our wheel hub, or we can say wheel. Okay, on which tire is mounted. Clear? And different types of loads which are acting on the axles, which type of load which is bearing by the axle, that is the weight of the body, or we can say weight of the vehicle, occupants or goods. Okay, that is on the axles. Okay, next is driving thrust. Driving thrust is nothing but the driving torque which comes on that axles, and a reactive torque which acting with through the road wheel, that is a driving thrust which act on the axle, that is bear by the rear axle. Next is torque reaction. Torque reaction is nothing but it is comes on the bevel pinion, and it is bevel pinion torque is bear by the that shaft. Okay, next is side thrust. Side thrust is nothing but it is comes due to the while you turning your vehicles, side forces comes on that wheel, and the wheel is transferred to that axle, that is known as a side thrust. Okay, so this diagram is showing for that weight of the body, weight of total weight of the body, suppose we can W, and this is acting W by 2 on the suspension, and through the suspension it comes on the rear axles, and so that's why we opposite reaction, suppose it is a simply we like assume that it is a simply supported beam, that's why two supports left from the wheel acting on that axles, that is the R1 and R12. Okay, next, our in basically to bearing this four types of load, various types of designs are there, in which two types of main design which is used in our vehicle design. Okay, basically according to the load conditions and various loads which can bear by the axles, so we use two types of design, in which mainly we often generally we used many of vehicles, that is a Hotchkiss types of drive. Okay, so let me start the what is Hotchkiss type of drive. Okay, this is a very very important questions for the exam point of view. Let me understand Hotchkiss type, what is Hotchkiss type, and another one is a torque tube type drive. Okay, so let me understand clearly what is Hotchkiss type of drive. In Hotchkiss type of drive, this is nothing but let me understand first construction and what is the its function. Okay, basically we understand that axles is used to bear the load. Okay, four types of load are there Okay, which four types of load? This is the four types of load: weight of the vehicle, driving thrust, torque, and side load. Okay, so here these are the nothing but this is the frame of the our vehicle. Okay, this is the frame of the our vehicle, and on which spring are there. The spring is nothing but this is the leaf spring are there. In every vehicle, spring is there. Okay, this is leaf spring, and this leaf spring is connected with the frame. Here it is a rigid joint is provided at the one end of the leaf spring, and another end of the leaf spring is connected, or we can say another is nothing but a rear side of leaf spring is connected to cycle. Cycle is provided to move its own axis. That's why it is like a pendulum type. So if cycle is provided, that means after if load comes on that spring, that means after some time it moves here and after some time it's moved here. That's why it moves like on that axis is a pendulum type. Okay, in such a way that, but it is a rigid body, so it cannot move. Okay, so load comes on that here. So basically this springs is nothing but it can bear the all four types of load. In Hotchkiss type of drive, all four load can be bear by that vehicles. Okay, which four load? Torque reaction, okay, driving thrust, and driving thrust, and cornering force, or we can say side thrust, or we can, or weight of the load, which can bear by this leaf spring. And this leaf spring is nothing but it is connected to the axles. Okay, here axles are provided. Okay, in plane of the our screen. Okay, like this, these are the our axle. These are the our axles on which leaf spring is there. This is the leaf spring. Okay, leaf spring is nothing but it is the used to bear a load, all four types of load which can be bear by that leaf spring. Okay, leaf spring is nothing but the arrangement of this leaf spring is like this shape. Okay, this is the one leaf spring. Okay, over another leaf spring is below this one, and like this. Okay, these are the leaf spring, and the first leaf spring is nothing but that is known as a for master leaf spring. Okay, which can more and more load can be bear by this master leaf spring. Okay, so next we proceed on the next constructional type. Okay, these are the propeller shaft. Okay, these are the propeller shaft from here to here. This propeller shaft is transmit a power from the gearbox. These are the gearbox to the differential. Okay, or we can say bevel pinion. First it transmit the power to bevel pinion. Okay, this is bevel pinion. So connection of propeller shaft to gearbox and bevel pinion by using of two differential two universal coupling, or we can say universal joint are used. Okay, so these two universal joint are used in between propeller in between of gearbox and we can say bevel pinion shaft. Okay, so why universal joint is provided? Because universal joint it can permit to some alignment, angular alignment, we can say 10 to 14 or 15 degrees alignment if some loads are bear. Okay, so it can adjust itself when the one side of wheel will up and down when the speed breaker comes. Okay, on the speed breaker, that's why it is used a propeller shaft on both end. Okay, on both end this propeller shaft is two universal joint is used on both end. And one thing also provided on the propeller shaft, that is a sliding joint. Okay, here sliding joint are provided so that it can slides propeller shaft is slide. Sliding joint is provided to function is that when load on the wheel, or we can say speed breaker comes to the one side of wheel when wheel up and down, so that it a universal joint, this end can rotate in circular way. That's why it can up and down. The propeller shaft movement is up and down, so alignment if it is rigid it can break. Okay, propeller shaft break. So the distance if it is upside, so that way distance is like that, it increases. If suppose it like downward, the distance is increases. So this distance is compensating by the providing this sliding joint here. Okay, by providing the sliding joint here. So remember, sliding joint is by providing in that condition. So this is the propeller shaft, and here bevel pinions, and the Hotchkiss. This is our nothing but Hotchkiss drive. Okay, so it can bear the all types of load. Okay, and you can see easily in the some of the vehicle you can see the propeller shaft easily, differential, open differential mechanism you can see easily. Okay, this is the rear casing, and the work of spring we also explain in this video. So the load comes from the gearbox, okay, so it transmitted to this differential motor. These are the our Hotchkiss type of drive. And another one is a torque tube drive. Torque tube drive is a special type of drive, okay. This is mainly used in the heavy vehicles, and this is very costlier, okay. Cost of this torque tube drive is very much more compared to the Hotchkiss drive. And Hotchkiss drive is used in a car or light duty vehicles, but torque tube drive is used in the heavy vehicles, okay. This diagram, okay, this diagram is nothing but the this one, okay. So it is zoom out from here, that's what it taken from that side, okay. So similar, like this is a frame, okay. These are the leaf spring, but here leaf spring is connected with the two cycles are provided. Two cycles is used to bear only weight of the vehicles, okay, load, okay. So other loads, okay, driving thrust, or we can say torque thrust and side thrust, which can this can only side thrust, okay. And other loads, other three loads which can be bear by the this torque tube, okay. This torque tube. So here what happened, the one end of torque tube is rigidly connected with this differential mechanism, and other end is connected with the fastening with the coupling, okay. Fastening with the coupling, two ends, this is the fastening with the coupling, and here rigidly connected. And in torque tube, propeller shaft is inside there, okay. That means it is a covered it, okay. These are our torque tube, suppose it is a torque tube, and in which propeller shaft is covered. That means you cannot see in open eyes or naked eyes the propeller shaft. Just you see the this is we can say torque tube, okay. So it can bear the torque, total torque, driving torque, or we can say torque reaction, all are the bear by this driving torque. So this is directly connected with this differential mechanism, and the other end, so in that some different is there, the other end is provided some circular or ball type of joint is provided. In that universal joint is there, in that you can see in that figure, okay. These are the ball type of other end is ball type of torque tube, and in which universal joint is there, and this is a propeller shaft, and is connected with this gearbox. And this all the mechanism is assembled in this cup shape, okay. The cup shape is provided, okay. Here is cup shape, and then it connected to the gearbox. These are the torque tube drive. This is a very important, and it can bear the more and more load. So it is a very costlier, and it is used in a heavy vehicle, okay. But one note is there, in both type of drives the side thrust is taken by the leaf spring. Just remember, the side thrust is taken by the leaf spring. If coil spring are used, they are not able to take a side load, and therefore a simple separate number is employed in that case, okay. This that is called Panhard. So in previous video we discussed about the Panhard, just we talked about the name Panhard, okay. These are the Panhard, nothing but this Panhard. The one end of Panhard is connected with the frame, and other end with the axles, okay. So when side thrust comes on the wheel, it can be bear by this Panhard, okay. This is used to bear the side thrust, so we use the Panhard. You can easily see in the every vehicles the Panhard is provided. A Panhard is also called Panhard bar, track rod, and suspension link. This is a crossbar, okay, we can say crossbar. And radius rods, radius rod is also provided for the compensating of the torque reaction, okay, for the compensating of torque reaction. So for torque reaction we provided the radius rod, okay. These are the parallel to the longitudinal axis. So this is the diagram of radius rod and Panhard. So you can easily make the function of the in ask one type in MCQ exams, you can easily ask the pan work of Panhard rod and radius rod. The work of Panhard to bear the side thrust, okay, and radius rods is used to torque reaction which comes on that vehicle, so it can be compensated by. So thank you so much to we can so today in this lecture we understand the Hotchkiss drive or torque tube drives, okay. These are the rear axles type of chapters, okay. So thank you so much guys.